Whatever he does, it always looks like a theater performance. He is an eccentric man and an extraordinary painter. His worldview differs from the world perception of other people, and sometimes he is like a character in Dostoevsky's novel. He makes scenography of performances, exhibitions of paintings, writes collections of poems, and gives lessons. Besides, he is very fond of cinema. It is Fedir Aleksandrovych who is engaged in all the activities. What motivates the painter and gives him creative vitality? Watching this program. I take a creative approach to all kinds of my work. I'm engaged in different activities. I can use the same idea in theater, in cinema, and in poetry. If I can't express the idea in poetry, I can use it in cinema. Otherwise, if I fail to make a movie, I can find the right expression of the idea in poetry. Theatergoers are well familiar with the creative work of the shock performances of artist Fedir Aleksandrovych. He tours throughout the country together with the different stage directors. Fedir has already staged over 40 performances, but recently he became famous among filmmakers. Besides that, he became popular not only in Ukraine, but abroad as well. I'm engaged in painting, theater activity, poetry, and cinema. I'm fond of different activities, but I never thought I would engage in an investigation into the consequences of the Chernobyl disaster. The Russian Woodpecker is a Ukrainian movie that won the Best Foreign Documentary Film nomination among more than 12,000 movies at the Sundance International Festival Independent Film. The film was directed by American film director Chad Gracia. But Fedir Aleksandrovych is the author of the idea based on a fable, and he played the lead role in the film. I used the philosophy of plastic conflict in the film. It has never been used before in cinema. So this is one of the reasons why the film won the Square Dance Festival. It also has a unique compositional structure, apart from its pressing theme. The Russian Woodpecker film is based on the personal investigation of Fedir about the Duga radar station that is situated close to the Chernobyl nuclear power plant. He is strongly convinced that Duga personifies the so-called unconquerable problems of our past that need to be overcome.
Не существовало теоретической базы для ее работы, и она уже работать не могла.
Not only film director Chad Gracia, but also a large team of foreign film experts took part in the film's making. Close friend and like-minded person of Fedir, cameraman Artem Ryshkov, who won the prize for the best camera work at the Sundance Festival, also lent support to the author of the idea. Archivists and historians also made a great contribution to the making of this film. Thus, Fedir Aleksandrovych appears as the leading character of the movie. He is extraordinary and naive. He strives to convey the truth about the Chernobyl disaster to humanity. To make a truthful image of the character, film director Chad Gracia shows the most important thing for the audience – his theory.
Ради сохранения карьеры московского чиновника.
The Russian Woodpecker is a documentary film. All the events shown in the film are absolutely real. This is verified information that meets the standards of Western journalism. Otherwise, the BBC can't show the movie if it doesn't meet the standards. There are witnesses confirming that not only the information is real, but the hypothesis itself is quite realistic and proven. A radio signal used during the Cold War was called the Russian Woodpecker. According to Aleksandrovych, the Soviet authorities spent money on the construction of the Duga secret installation to monitor the launch of American missiles. They spent twice the sum of money that then was spent on the construction of the Chernobyl nuclear power plant. The installation was a steel structure that was higher than the Great Pyramids of Cheops. But in early 1986, it became clear that Duga was not operating. In Fedir's opinion, the Chernobyl NPP was blown up to conceal a failure in construction of the radar installation.
А это не яд.
Яд выходит, видишь, яд.
We drew this conclusion through criminal investigation conducted by five individuals working in the archives. Sometimes we met with people and conducted an interview, which lasted for 8-10 hours. Having learned about this, I was left in a total state of shock. The movie consists of several stories, but the main story is Fedir's personal story, his evolution from a five-year-old boy who suffered from the Chernobyl accident to a man fighting with ghosts of the Soviet past. All the plot lines intersect the events of Euromaidan. Fedir Aleksandrovych is convinced that the Chernobyl accident, Euromaidan, and the war in the east of Ukraine are the vestiges of Soviet power that still doesn't want to let go of Ukraine and give its people peace of mind. In the opinion of the young filmmaker, The Russian Woodpecker is a new format of so-called thriller film. This is a movie that could influence the making of documentaries in the future, and one that hopes to attract a wide audience.
Ukraine is still struggling with that.
Русский дятел видели миллионы людей, то есть это все-таки десятки, ну так как он.
Millions of people watched The Russian Woodpecker. It was shown by the ART channel and BBC. It was presented at more than 100 festivals. It was shown in a prime time on several occasions and was watched by nearly 50 million people. In my opinion, this movie is very important in fighting with our enemy, Russia. You can't hide from this war. This is a cultural war. The movie influenced people and was in a way a political explanation of all the events occurring around the world today. Inspired by the raging success of his documentary in screen art, Fedir Aleksandrovych continued to master this scope of activity, creating independent cinema. Fedir presupposes that in order to engage in cinema, it is necessary to have the support of colleagues, so Artem Ryshkov was a like-minded person for him. It is he who helped Aleksandrovych shoot several short-length films, which received high recognition at many film festivals. Among his first movies is the short film Hindrance. Fedir and Artem worked on the movie for about 2 years. They thought up every shot. The movie won 3 grand prizes at once at different film festivals. I got to know about Буйницкий's idea embodied in the film Hindrance, and I liked it very much. We, jointly with Artem, made a design in style of the 1930s to create the atmosphere of the past. This is a small narration of harms. This is a very good idea to show children, playing in relations between adults. The kids watched a dramatic scene of the shooting of repressed people and tried to repeat it. They recreated events occurring in the
1930s.
Film director Fedir Aleksandrovych and cameraman Artem Ryshkov succeeded to make a debut, having shot a feature-length film. They directed a movie fairy tale titled Bright Snake, based on a Lithuanian fairy tale. This is a co-production of Ukraine, Lithuania and Latvia. Merited artist and singer Yuri Strenga and actress Skaidra Janchaitė, who impressed Fedir with her performance during Euromaidan, starred in the movie. The film is almost ready. Authors of the film are impatiently waiting for its release. We have already finished shootings and made the montage. Now we're working with sound. It is very important for me to create a movie shape. I wanted to make something unusual and interesting in order to show myself as a painter. So the legend is a so-called auteur film. Although Fedir Aleksandrovych is enthusiastic about cinema, he remains committed to painting. He paints pictures and lectures at the Art Academy, but he often looks for inspiration to create poetry and cinema by isolating himself from society and spending time before sitting at the easel to draw and paint. I took part in many exhibitions, starting with galleries by Brancusi. I combined painting with work in theater because my postgraduate work was dedicated to the Holodomor topic. I made sketches for costumes. They looked like big paintings from the film Grain Storage. This story about famine, the genocide, and these portraits is one of the main works for me. I'm going to hold an exhibition in San Francisco. I hope it will take place and that sketches, which are very important for me, will be showcased there.
И там как бы будут представлены эти эскизы, которые для меня очень важны.
Whatever Fedir does, his main goal is to learn something new, giving lessons to students, and when preparing before the lessons, he tries to develop his creative abilities and perfect himself in the discovery of the world.
Свои познания мира.
Так получилось, что занимаешься всем.
It turns out that I am engaged in many activities. I would like to say that I can make something for the development of my profession as a teacher, but a teacher shouldn't try to make students similar to him. The students have to excel and be better than him. The teacher has to become the so-called star for his students, in order that they reach it and achieve more than their pedagogue. I think this is the main goal of learning. Fedir Aleksandrovych considers the profession of stage designer to be intellectual and philosophic. Trying to comprehend the world with the help of his creative work, the artist can tell things that can be hardly expressed by a film director or playwright, who built the concept of the performance. A painter can tell about banned things through his creative work and images created by him. Nowadays, it is better to stage modern plays because you can tell about banned things in clear text, and it is enough for staging a theater performance. In Fedir's opinion, work with different film directors at different theaters is a good way to gain experience and skills. Belarusian staging of the play Tamers of Fire or Fairy Tales about Monica is one such example. The artist made an interior decoration using iron boxes, which were relocated during the performance and were used for the construction of various objects. Theater is so-called provocation. The viewer has to comprehend it without someone's help, but not stoop up to the level of theater. Only in such a case does it make sense. Theater is a stage institution, but its loyalty is to convey urgent issues from the stage. Fedir Aleksandrovych also shows his vision of the acting space in the Ukrainian classical format. A performance titled The Miserable, based on a play by Ivan Karpenko-Kari, was staged at the Kyiv Theater in the Lipke district. The young artist supposes that cooperation with stage director Maxim Holenko played an important role in the development of his creative work. They staged a series of avant-garde plays together, among them are the Three Penny Opera by Bertolt Brecht, staged at the Luhansk Theater. And Gogol's V, that was adapted to contemporary drama by Natalia Voroshbyt and staged at the Kyiv Art Center Pasika. One interesting story happened with us in Luhansk. We staged the latest performance right before the events of Euromaidan. It was the Three Penny Opera, under a different title, Imitation of Fashion Vices. We foresaw certain events of the Euromaidan revolution. In our play we showed bandits who looked like thugs for hire. In it you can see riot police officers with shields and people in quilted jackets, defending their city. Of course, we felt the coming of events and told about them in our play. Fedir confesses that joint work with Maxim Holenko constantly gives him energy and inspiration for new creative research. At this time, they presented joint performances in Germany at the Wild East Phenomena of Ukraine Theater Festival. Work with actors of the Magdeburg City Theater inspired the painter to create stage design for a new version of the play V. We worked on the staging of the play V together with Maxim Holenko. Initially, we staged it at the Pasika Art Center studio of Igor Bilitz. When we performed in Magdeburg, we completely changed it. We used only the same theatrical costumes and scenic design. It was cross-shaped and consisted of small plates. Flying bars were raised up and the cross structure was dispersed. It was very beautiful. It differed from the scene design we used in another version of the play. I and Maxim have already staged about 10 performances. It was very interesting for me to work with him. He is selective and has good taste, and he always helped me as an artist. And maybe I helped him as a director. Fedir Aleksandrovych determined for himself several top priority forms of activity. He makes experiments, searches for creative concepts, and realizes them. Whatever the critics write, however the audience responds, the main thing for him is sincerity and an honest attitude towards his profession. Fedir is convinced if a person does really good and high quality work, it has a major impact on the development of the country as a whole.
Я бы сказал о том, каким должен быть мир, как должно быть устроено место, где я живу, как должна выглядеть.
With the help of my creative work, I want to express how I see the world and my country where I live. So it was always interesting for me to engage in such creativity, because very often people follow rules prescribed by somebody. These people walk down a narrow path without knowing that they found big stones on the roadside. So nobody knows. There could be diamonds on the adjacent road.